it's one of these.
It's from like a flyer.
Just a little information.
So then it rotates a lot of things.
Thank you.
Oh, see, I thought that I needed more listening.
So we're ready whenever you are. Well, thank you guys for letting me come in and interrupt your day. How many of you guys are familiar with the services you have with Circlepix?
And I took
a banana
and on a call class on it, like she showed me how to do it, because I do the admin part in the back end, so I didn't realize it had as many functions available to it as it did, so that's why I thought it'd be good to get you in. And
yeah, I mean, that's what we hear from a lot of offices, they just because it runs automatically, yeah. But people don't realize there are some things you can do to enhance your listings as well. So the first question is, is this your tour viewer that you're using now?
It's not the new one. We're still using the old one. I haven't swapped over yet.
Okay, so we want to swap you over because we're trying to phase out all the old ones. So we'll get into that. all right, let's just go ahead and get started. So I guess a little bit of a history so you guys can know who Circlepix is. We got started 18 years ago. This was last year's PowerPoint. We should update that, I guess, because this is our anniversary month. 18 years this month in business as a photography company. Started out just doing photography in Provo, Utah, just right near Brigham Young University. And that has now spread all over the country to where we're in 19,000 different zip codes. We have one of the largest photography networks in the United States. But if you remember 2008, I remember it fondly. I was a landscape contractor in Vegas, one of the largest there. When the economy kind of took its correction, we started looking at what we were doing as a company at Circlepix and said, how can we better assist agents moving into what we felt was going to be a new economy? Because really coming out of 2008, going into where we are now, everything was going online. And so we wanted to really increase online presence. And since then, we've enhanced even more what we do to get you further engaged in social media. And we're the pioneers in all of this automation. We were the first company that said we can completely automate real estate marketing, which means that it kind of puts us like the Apple with the iPhone, right? They were the first one to bring the touchscreen smartphones to market, like them or love them. They brought it to market, and everybody else has had to chase them, and they've had to keep ahead. Sometimes they haven't, sometimes they have. But we try to keep ahead of all of our competition, so we're constantly innovating and creating and making better. And so that's a lot of times why you don't realize how many more tools you really have at your fingertips, because we'll create something new, and we'll send out emails that will let you know, and you just see a Circlepix email, and you may pass it by. Don't pass those emails by, because they're gonna tell you some of the things we're doing. We'll talk about some new stuff that's coming out that's included with what you have. So for sake of time here, we have a three-prong approach when it comes to marketing. Number one is photography. We really feel like marketing a home, that it really starts with great photography. So are you guys using professional photography, or are you taking your own? Okay, you're using professional photography. That's great. Now you can use our photography. You can go right online to circlepix.com, click on Pix Photography. You can select a package. They generally run anywhere from $119 to $139, depending on what you want for your photography. We train all of our photographers to shoot in HDR imagery for that front shot of the home. We want that front shot to be really good, clear, crisp images, just like you're seeing there. That's where the story begins. If you have a large home, a custom home, maybe you want to do a video commercial on, we can do those as well. Just down at the bottom, there's a videography. When you click on Pix Photography, go all the way to the bottom, there'll be a button that you can push for to select the videography, and we can do a full video commercial on those properties as well. However, it doesn't matter what you're doing from a photography standpoint. So you can be using our photographer, you can be using your own photographer, you can be taking your own photographs. The system that you have that already is called Pix Marketing. You put your listing on the MLS and we do the rest. So literally you go, you go out, you do all your negotiations, you take your shots, have your you go and upload that to the MLS. Our system reaches out and grabs that listing and will create a 20-point online marketing campaign absolutely automatically for that listing. If anything changes to that listing, you do a price change, you swap out the photos, anything that affects the marketing, you just make that change in the MLS, and our system recognizes that change and will go through and update all of that marketing for you. And when it's sold, it's deactivated and gone away. So you don't need to worry about, is there something left out there that I need to worry about? So really quickly, what I want to do today is I want to show you what we create for you. Okay, what innovation tools do we have, automation tools. How do we get exposure? How do we get that exposed out to the world? By using the links through the MLS and also your social media, and how we can generate more leads for you guys, and tips, the tricks that you can use to communicate with some of the leads, and how we communicate with you. So first off, the first thing we create is an individual property website for every single listing. Now you guys are using our, like she said, our old tour viewer, and we wanna switch you guys to this new individual property website. Here's what we did. We completely rebranded our company in 2015. During that rebrand, we looked at everything we were doing, including our tours, and we found that people were not watching the tour. They were going in and just clicking on the photos. We had some lead generation built into the site through a guest book, and nobody was clicking on that. It was just too much. So what we did is we went to a 3.0 property website. We're giving people exactly what they would see on a traditional site. So this flows like a traditional website. Now what this view that we have here is our edge-to-edge viewer, meaning that the photos you can see go edge-to-edge, and there's a button right here that they just click on that arrow and they'll be able to see those photos. They can click right through them just like they normally would want to do. Now they can come up, sorry, it's really hard to do this over your shoulder, and click on the gallery view, and that will put the photos into more of a grid pattern for them. But the key is they can look at the photos just like they want to. Now, I did not want to do that. Let's go back to presentation. There is music and voice that will play on this as well.
Please enjoy.
But over here is our first lead generator. See that down in the corner where my head was, I guess, is the share button. So built right into the photos is our first lead generator. So I could, if I was looking at this property, I'm sorry, what was your name?
Renee.
Yeah. So let's say this is Renee's property and my wife is home and she's searching for properties for sale that we're looking for. She sees this one, maybe I learned how to click. And she says, you know what, I think Marty wants to see this. So she would go in and put her name and cell phone number, my name and cell phone number. She would click send, and it would send me a text saying that Allison thought that you might be interested in this property. And it would give me a link to open up the mobile version of this property site. Well, Renee's the agent. Just as quickly as I'm getting that text, Renee would get a text saying, Allison just sent this to Marty. So he could pick up the phone and he could call Marty or he could call Allison. I'd be smart, he calls my wife because she makes all the decisions. She's just saying, here, this is a thought for you to look at. And he could start that relationship, start to find out what they're looking for. But that's a true lead that's been generated. It's not a captured lead. So there's different lead generators we're going to talk about as we go throughout this property site. The key to them are, if you're getting a lead from these property sites, somebody's taking the time to fill it out. It's not a capture lead, it's a quality lead.
What site is that? So you're saying that's the RE/MAX site.
Well, this is the property, it looks just like your RE/MAX website, doesn't it?
Yeah.
That's the point. This is the individual property website we create for you. So here's how they're finding this site.
Right.
Okay. Once we get this created, you get an email from us that says, your marketing's done. Mm-hmm. In that email, there are several links. You have a regular tour link and a non-branded tour link.
Right.
You're going to copy the non-branded tour link, mm-hmm. and you're going to paste it into your MLS.
Right.
Because we cannot push information into your MLS.
Right.
Okay. So now what you've done is you've linked this property site to the MLS. Now when the MLS sends their syndication out, this link goes with the syndication. So the 300 different sites that they're syndicating to, this follows. So let's say I'm at Zillow or Realtor.com. As I'm scrolling down, there'll be a button that says virtual tour. They click on that and it opens into this website. This exact website, the branded site. Because see, even though you sent the non-branded link to the MLS, our system is very, very sophisticated. What our system says is, okay, that brand, non-branded tour link was clicked at realtor.com, and it converts that tour to their website to a branded site because we can, because it was loaded outside the MLS. Does that make sense?
Right.
No other company can do that. Or at least they haven't figured it out yet. We have. We've been doing it for years. So you rest assured, by putting that brand, non-branded tour link in the MLS, you will always get your branded information loaded at any of the aggregates.
I just have a quick question. When I copy the link, the unbranded, it takes forever. It's like a game I have to play with that link. It doesn't, you know how it goes over the link, darkens the link so that you can click copy and then you paste it. In order to copy it, I don't know if it's my computer or what, it takes a game to get it to all copy at one time so I can paste it.
Have you done it right from the email we sent you?
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Anybody else having that problem?
I don't use the virtual tours.
I've made it myself. It's really simple.
I do it all the time, but it's a game I have to play with the damn link.
I would have to be looking at what you're doing with your computer, but because
all I'm doing
that.
Is, you know, holding it down, copying it, but it sometimes copies it right away. And sometimes
you paste into the virtual tour link.
The problem with pasting it. Okay. It's getting it copied.
Yeah, I think it's your computer, because I have that issue with my Mac. Whereas if I'm going to copy something, if I'm not like careful, it copies the whole page rather than.
Oh yeah, no.
How
but
about
that's
right click copy link, right?
What is it?
Right click copy link.
No, I did that.
You can hover right over that link.
Yeah.
And right, you don't have to copy the whole thing.
Okay.
You can right click on the link,
right.
And it will say copy.
Oh, yes. Okay.
You don't have to try and highlight
that.
That's
what I have to do. Okay.
You right click on that link, and it will bring up a drop down box.
Okay. And you don't have a virtual tour, right? If it was panoramic.
I have access to the MLS and to your Circlepix account.
Mm-hmm.
I can do all that for you if you want.
Oh. It's like a 2-second thing. Yeah. Once I get it copied, and then I just paste it right into the MLS.
We have been working with MLSs. It depends on how we get your feed. That's one of the things we're working with all MLSs, is that why can't we just push that link back?
Yeah.
Right. It's needed information, and sometimes it's because your MLS has a relationship with somebody that's providing a crappy tour for you.
Right. Panoramic tour.
They do, the panoramic tour, which always comes in on the first virtual tour.
You say no, I think.
And then I have to erase that to put yours in because
yours you're smart to erase it because that's a horrible tour.
Say no on the, when you fill it says virtual, say no, then it won't come in, I think.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it doesn't come in. Oh, okay.
Just say no on the MLS.
So you've got your phone. What's your name?
Jessica.
So let me just test this so you guys can see how it works. So I'll go put in my name here. And my phone number. And let's put in Jessica. Jessica, what is your phone number?
727-491-8177.
Okay, so I'm going to click send here in a couple seconds. I want to see, I want you guys to see how quick this happens. Did you already get the text?
No.
Oh, I'm like, you made that face like.
No, because I'm like, right now the pressure's on. Like, hopefully it's not I use T-Mobile. Hopefully it's not my server.
Did it come through? It's got to be your.
Oh, there it is.
Okay, because I've already got an email that says that Marty sent this to Jessica. Yeah, so she's got the link.
Wow.
I'm the agent on this, and I've got an email, and I'll get a text, because I have mine set up to text me and email me,
right.
Saying that Marty sent this to Jessica. So quickly, I can pick up the phone and call Jessica or Marty and start that relationship. But just as quickly as she got the link.
Could you show us how the agents set up their profiles to make sure that they can do that?
We'll do that at the
end. Yeah, pictures and stuff,
nice. Awesome.
Okay, so. This is automatic.
It's talking to me now.
Stop it.
It's in your life.
But that was quick, right?
Yes, it was.
The end user wants it quick, and you as the agent want it just as quick as they're looking at it, because that's when they're going to remember that property. If it's delayed and they move to the next property, they forgot which it was. Mm-hmm. And I would want to call Jessica right away, or whoever sent that to her, but most likely Jessica, because I want to be that first agent to get in contact with her, okay? So now this is automatic. There are things you can do to enhance these sites to make them better. Are any of you guys doing drone videos on properties? I know that's getting really big in some areas.
Some of our agents are, and it's usually a drone property.
Yeah. Yeah.
Have you? And
I know Kenny. I've already had
Carlina
once.
Yeah.
Well, video is important. So whether it's drone video or video you're getting from YouTube, if you have a drone video, your drone photographer just gives you a YouTube link. You go into the back office on that listing. Wow, slow internet. So you go into the back office of that listing and you just copy and paste the video link that the drone photographer gives you, and it will link that drone video to this property site. I like to use lifestyle videos. So I will go look at the community where I'm listed, where the house is listed, and I will put, for example, I've got a listing in Parowan, Utah. It's right at the base of a ski resort. So I went and put in Welcome to Parowan. It's a small town, but they got a really cool video that talks about the history of the town and things that happened during the town during the year. And I pasted that link into that property site. This is one I found for Phoenix, that sells the lifestyle of Phoenix. There are plenty here for Florida. But that way it's really great because you have a lot of people moving in from other places and you can sell that lifestyle of the area around that home, okay? So you can use video. You can also take
And any, you can put that right into the MLS?
Now you put it into the back office at circlepix.com.
Oh, okay.
And that will link it to this property site,
which
will link it to the MLS, because it's non-branded, so it can play, right? The other thing I could do is I can, right from my phone, there I can download the Circlepix app. And with the app, I can create a video from my phone and upload to this property site. There was a guy that, I think it was in Missouri, he would stand in front of his property on his way out from getting the listing, and he would stop and he would grab his phone and said, "Hey, I just took this listing," and he'd do a little thing out in front of it, and he populates that to his property site. He's a millennial, right?
Yeah.
They love to see themselves on video anyway.
Yeah,
are you guys familiar with Matterport?
Yeah. Yes.
Heard of it. Is that the 3D thing?
Yeah. Really cool stuff, really expensive. Tours, right? The camera itself. I don't know if it's my computer.
No,
it could be out on your knees.
It's in the internet.
It doesn't seem like that button's clicking now. Mm-hmm. Anyway, you copy the link. The Matterport will give you a link. You copy that link and paste it into the back office underneath that listing at circlepix.com, and it'll attach your Matterport tour so that it's there as well. So the point of these tours are, we don't care what third party site you're using. You could have a virtual tour from another company. You can copy their link and paste it into our back office, and now our tour, their tour, your videos, your 3D tour, all of that gets sent out through the syndication at all of the aggregate sites.
You're gonna show us how to get to the back office.
Yes, ma'am.
Correct?
Yep. So now as we scroll down, it'll have all the information on that property, bedrooms, bathrooms, square foot price. It'll go to your agent information. Your photo will display. I did a RE/MAX training yesterday, and doing their setup, I deleted my photo. So my photo doesn't show, but you can see me in person. So your photo would show right here. Has all your information. There's a button here to schedule a showing. That's another lead generator. We link to your agent website. We link out to all of your social media. And with our app, you can create a video bio of yourself. So we really suggest you do a video bio of yourself because it personalizes your website. As they scroll down, there's information, other listings. So if you have multiple listings, that person, as they're going down, will be able to see your other listings. They can click on it and view that listing. We have three mortgage calculators built in there. Each one of those are a lead generator. We have your brochures. You know, you get an email that lets you download this, but one of them is in here, so I could, if I was looking at this, I could email it to myself or my wife. That's a lead generator. There's school information. It's both public and private, but we have that set up as a lead generator as well to request school information. The next section is the walk score. So how walkable is this property to downtown? This is still loading, so it's really slow internet. Wow. And then weather information, and then at the bottom, mapping instructions.
They keep telling me it's my router.
I don't know what it is. That is the slowest
internet.
This is an internet. Just get on a different internet than we would.
Yeah, but over there, it's still a problem. Yeah.
So all of that's created automatically. Now, how many of you guys have set up a YouTube channel for yourselves?
I have, but I have two for some reason. I don't know why. And I don't know.
That's the thing. We have two Remax ones as well.
Why is that?
I have no idea. One of them, I have both of them connected to our Remax Facebook page. One of them I control because I have the Gmail account for it. The other one, it isn't branded or anything because we can't verify it because we don't know what email address it's linked to. It could be that we had someone here before who's no longer with us, that maybe they set it up, but we don't know. Is there any way that you can find out where it's linked to?
Is that where we're putting the videos under the one that you don't have access to?
I have access to it as I can view it, but I don't have access to the back end of the YouTube page.
We need to have your account manager switch it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, right, okay, so I can contact Jennifer.
Yeah, Jennifer's, I don't know if she's back from maternity leave, so we're going to have you talk to Natalie.
Okay.
So you can track what channels you have and then maybe get rid of one?
Because both of them are on, and it's the one that's unbranded that's not the most used. Not the one that's branded.
Well, I always get two emails and it says like identical. And why do I have two YouTube?
So, yeah, we want to put them where you have access. So maybe we need to move. Talk to Natalie. We can move everything over onto the channel that you have access to. We can give you artwork to get the branding up into the banner section.
Yeah, I've already got all that, but I can't put it into that YouTube channel because I don't have access to that YouTube channel. I don't know the Gmail account that's linked to it or the whatever account that YouTube account is linked to. And nobody in the company knows because I've contacted everyone who could have possibly set it up.
Let's talk to Natalie and see if we can figure it out. If not, maybe need to get everything stopped, sending anything to that channel
and push everything
to the channel where we know.
Okay.
And
I mean, it's got it both right now, but both channels. So I've got both of them set up onto
like a duplicate.
Mm. Yeah, well, we want to shut the non-brand. We want to stop sending to the non-branded. We don't want anything going there because they're not. It just doesn't. And you can't verify it, so the videos don't look right on there because it doesn't. If you're unverified, it'll have a random photo that starts instead of the front shot of the home.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's in fact. See, this has been verified. This channel, and so it's showing the front shot. So you do want to set up your own YouTube channel. It's really simple. You set up a Gmail account. And Gmail email, and then there's like a box at the top that has a bunch of squares that you click on and go to the bottom and you select YouTube and it lets you set up a YouTube account. The reason why you want Google's algorithm says anything that you have on a Google product ranks higher in the Google search, right? So by loading one video to the Office YouTube channel and one video to your agent YouTube channel, if they do a Google search for agent, real estate agent in, where are we at, Palm Harbor?
Mm-hmm.
I was in Miami a couple days ago. I've been from Miami up to here. So if I do real estate agent in Palm Harbor, anybody with more information on Facebook, Twitter, Blogger, YouTube, all of that, which we are doing for you guys, it helps rank you higher in those Google searches. Furthermore, when somebody Googles an address, video is the first thing that shows up. Literally, it's one of the first things in their deal. So when they click on those videos, it'll have a nice entrance screen. This is the old-fashioned pan and zoom virtual tour, and it always has your agent information displayed, and at the very end, a nice exit screen so that they know who to contact on that listing. And then when they scroll down, they can get all the information on that home. Here's the link that'll take them back to that virtual tour, that property site that we created for you. So from YouTube, we can get them back into the lead generation. When I click show more information, I can scroll down. There's all the information on that property, bedrooms, bathrooms, square foot price. And then we're linking back to the Office and Agent YouTube channels, your agent website. Those link backs really boost your Google search as an agent, and it boosts the Google search of that property. They just say properties for sale. Your property is ranked higher because of what we're doing there. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Facebook. Now, you get a listing, and if you do the setup wizard, and I'll show you the setup wizard, I'm not gonna go completely through it so I don't keep deleting things, but I'll show you how simple it is. We automatically post your listings directly to your Facebook page for you. There's a lot of stuff on this page. There's a listing there. There's another listing, another listing. Here's a listing. Every time you get a listing, it'll automatically post to your Facebook page. In your setup, you can say, you can have it repost either weekly or monthly until that property sold. So I'll show you in the setup, but what I've done with mine is, as again, I'm an agent, so anytime I get a listing, I have it post directly to my personal and my business page right after the listing's taken, and then every week it reposts to my business page until that property is sold. But I only have it hit my personal page one time, okay? Now, you can add this app. You have to call our customer service to have them walk you through it. But you can add this app called My Listings to your Facebook page.
I actually have the instructions. They sent me the instructions
to
do that. Yeah. So if you want to, I can actually send the instructions to you.
So when they click on that, it'll let them shop your personal inventory through Facebook using the slide bars, bedrooms, bathrooms, square foot price. So if you have multiple listings, it's really nice because they don't have to scroll through your timeline to find your listings. They can do that. Now from the office website, they can shop all of the office social media right through Facebook. So if they're on the office Facebook page, they can click on that and shop all of the office social listings. So that's what we do with your Facebook and your YouTube. Where did my mice go? There we go. In the setup wizard, it's really simple. You just copy your URL for Facebook and you paste it in a certain spot, and I'll show you. Same thing with Twitter, same thing with Blogger, same thing with LinkedIn. Okay, and once you're done with that setup wizard, you never need to touch this system again. Like we said, it'll hit your Facebook page, repost weekly or monthly. It hits your Twitter page one time, and we hashtag that by city and state because those hashtags are now searchable. We post it to your Blogger account if you have one, but LinkedIn is really important because it keeps you in front of your professional networks. I'm going to skip over that one. That's more office related. We produce your flyers for you. Actually, you're in here, so you need to see this. So, do you know about the message board tool?
No.
Okay. We have a tool for Facebook. It's in the back office for your admin. Okay. That lets you create messages for the office. So let's say you had your award ceremony and you wanted to recognize the top 10 agents or whatever, right? You could go into this message board. We want to congratulate, and then you do your posts, and you post it. It'll post to the office Facebook page, and then it'll post to every agent's Facebook page as if they made that post themselves.
Here, but it says broadcast message.
Yes.
Okay.
So that way you can post it one time to that message board, it hits your office Facebook page, and then every connected agent's Facebook page as well. So if you're doing a recruiting event, you can use that to leverage the power of these guys' center of influence. If you're doing a community event, whatever. Flyers, we take the first 4 to 6 images from the MLS. So when I load my listing to the MLS, I think about my flyer. I think put the first 4 to 6 images, put the first 6 images, so that my flyer does use 6 images. I put the first 6 images that I would want on my flyer into the MLS first. That way I don't have to go and regenerate my flyer. Then you'll get an email that says, click here, let you download the PDF version of this flyer, and you can download it, print it here, or send it to a local printer to be printed, okay? Most offices don't even know that we give this to you. Did you know about the 24 information line short code texting?
Yes.
Okay. Well, you just went through a training. Yeah. So, I don't know if you know, but NAR statistics say that 60% of people that view a property online are going to drive by that property. The challenge is that when they drive by that property, it's great they're going to Google that address because we can get them into the lead generation for you. But moreover, if there is a 24 information line on that property, it is very highly used. They are the single greatest lead generator you can put on a property. So what we've done is that we give you there's a local phone number for your office, and then you have access to the sign writer. She can give you access to the PDF so you can have a sign writer printed, or if the office is printing them. But you have your sign company print this sign, And in your email we send you that lets you know we're finished, there's a 4-digit extension that you put onto that that's specific to the property. So if this was my property and Jessica dialed this phone number, she would put in the extension. It would say press 1 to get a text and it would send her the mobile version of the property site. Or she'd press 2 and it'll let her hear the recorded information. Either way, it's going to capture her lead. It's going to text it and email it over to the agent in real time so that I could get in, so you can contact with them. Now, go ahead. You have a question?
I was just thinking, are these riders transferable? Because I've heard of these, we don't really utilize them that much, but I've heard that you have to just be ordering riders for every single home. So,
well, they transferable in
that. Exactly. So, say you want to use the same rider, say that house sold, put it on a different property. Can you guys on the back end, you know, change up the recording and change up the message?
Well, the recording is, all you would need to do is add the new extension. So, what some people are doing is they're using stickers from like
just
Walmart.
Putting it over top of every
time. They'll just pull the stickers will come off. It's vinyl. It's either vinyl or metal, right? And
like you just pull those. Cardboard or whatever.
So you can pull those off and put the new sticker on there.
Okay.
Or you guys have access to this. This is a set it and forget it. Mm-hmm. What we do, in fact, you guys have a unique name, Realtek. Mm-hmm. So Realtek could literally be your keyword. Did they talk to you about this?
No.
Okay. This is our short code texting. Do you guys understand short code texting?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, have you ever watched American Idol?
Yes.
Okay, on American Idol it says, if you want to vote for Renee, text Renee to, right? That's short code texting. What we would do is we could come up with the keyword, and I would suggest Realtek, because that's a unique tagline. All of your signs would say Realtek. How many agents do you have?
200.
Yeah.
All 200 can have the same sign in front of their listings. Mm-hmm. Here's how it would work. In this case, our keyword's Realtor. What was your name?
Sam.
Sam, if you were to text Realtor to 67299 and you were standing in front of that property, you would get a text back like Jessica did. But this time, when you click on the link, instead of going right to the property site, there'll be a button that says Find by Location. You click on that, and it's going to use your GPS device in your phone. It's going to match you up with the property you're in front of, load that property site, and then text and email the agent, the lead in real time. So this, Jessica, mm-hmm. I can move from listing to listing to listing to listing. Okay. Print 5 or 10 of them for myself, mm-hmm. and move them, and it'll work every time.
So what happens if they're outside the house, but they're driving, so they just take a picture of the sign, and they're at home, and they text that?
They could put in the address or the MLS number.
So if I have someone and I don't know the address, so I'm just driving through the street, I'm not going to know the address.
They can also access it through the listing finder. So it flips to a page where it pulls up all the listings. They can scroll through and find them.
Right. Okay. But it sounds like the first rider is a little bit more specific to that property because it mm-hmm. is attached to that extension. So maybe, I mean, you kind of have one or the other choice here, right? You're not going to put two riders on. So I don't know. You'll
find the one that works the best for you. You may want to try them out and see which one works best for you. Here's the deal. They're included. Mm-hmm. You don't have to go pay for another service. The leads are stored into your back office. And why is that important? Because it's where we're going next. So all these lead generators that we've got, there's 19 lead generators built into this system. So I know this never ever happens for you guys where you never have to reduce the price on a home, right?
Oh, we go higher.
Reduce rate. Yeah. It's like, oh, wait, we better raise the price.
It hasn't sold this year.
It's not
right. We must be underpriced.
Nobody wants to buy this house unless it's priced higher.
We target the people that put 50% offers in.
Yeah,
we got to price this in a minute. So you have that unrealistic buyer, right? So you come back, you sit down with them after however long, you've shown them statistics that's just we're not getting traction, reduce the price. All you need to do is update the MLS. Because that's going to update all of your marketing. Then what I would do is I'd click on that listing in my back office at circlepix.com, and there's a feature called batch texting, and I could say, I just met with the owners, they've reduced the price on this home, here's our new low price, let me know if you want to submit an offer. You click send, every lead generated on that will get that text with a copy of the property site attached to it, so they remember which property that you were talking about. You can also upload leads from other areas to use that as well. So maybe you've gotten some leads coming in from other sources or other agents. E-postcards, right from the email we send you, there's a button that says e-postcard. You click on that and it takes you right to the section in the back office that lets you do this. you type in whatever, you know, message you want to put in right here. You email this to yourself from the back office. You can email to your clients from the back office, but we only let you do 25 at a time. So it's just, it's easier to email this to yourself and then forward it out through your CRM. When they get this, if you send this to me, Sam, and I opened up my email, then when I open up that email, I don't have to click on anything to view it. Those the photos are automatically just switching inside that, what I call the Harry Potter photo frame.
Right.
Okay. They can click on this button, it'll take them to the virtual tour or whatever. You can schedule your open houses right from that email that we send you to let you know we're finished.
Yeah, I've been doing that every week. Friday I go in, check out all our open houses and do it for you. And then on the Monday I go in and delete them all. So,
yeah. Well, you don't need to delete them.
I'm doing that just to be anal.
You do that right now, you go in and do I go in and do that, and I always wonder, is this even really effective? Because honestly, I don't know where that goes, but I still go into MLS as well as like Neil and stuff.
This is,
so if I knew you're doing it,
I only go into the MLS, pull all our open houses, then I go into Circlepix and I put them all in.
I didn't know that. Well, now I'm not going to have to do
this. This gets attached to your property site. So when she does that, it activates another section on that property site, which is one of the first sections as it goes down, that says open house. And it'll give the days and times of two more lead generators to RSVP or get directions. Now, when that open house is over, it'll automatically deactivate and go away.
I just like to go in and delete it because I don't like to see them there.
You guys are so lucky to have her, let me tell you. Okay. Here's a ShamWow for you, coming soon, right? This may be done this month. Worst case scenario, I believe it'll be finished next month, is our brand new print suite. So this will be included for you guys. In the email you get from us, you will be able to download a PDF of your just listed, just sold flyers, postcards, and door hangers. You can literally send that over to the printer, have them printed, they're ready to go. Okay, and that's absolutely included. One other thing that we're working on to get added in this year is a live chat feature on that property site. That's in beta right now. We're testing it, we're working out all the bugs. So if I was in one of Jessica's property sites, her face would pull up in a little box and say, hey, this is Jessica, I'm the agent on this. Do you have any questions? I said, yeah, well, whatever question I have, I type it, I send, click send, it would send a text to Jessica. Jessica then right from her phone can text back and be communicating with somebody online with that property site. Okay. That's coming out this year. This is the email we send you that gives you your statistics. We'll send this to you weekly. This is the email you get from us that lets you know that the marketing campaign's been finished. It gives you your links, your 4-digit code for your sign writer. You can link out to your property site to do the things we've talked about. You have complete, even though it's automated, we've talked about today, you have control. There are things you can go and do to tweak this and make it, like we say in Utah, because they don't speak English very well, they're gooder and gooder. Yeah. Now, there are things that you can use to go and explain this in your next listing presentation. Right from your back office, and I forgot to bring these with me. I usually bring those as well as that. There's a brochure that prints out from the back office that says, thank you for considering me as your agent. You download that, and it'll print on the backside with your photo and the RE/MAX Realtek logo. But this brochure completely will walk you and your client through what you're going to do to market that listing. So everything we've talked about today is on that listing brochure. Or you just download the Circlepix app for your device. From the app, you can create a new automated listing presentation. You can take a photo, you can take any video and upload to your property site, and this is where you can do your agent bio. But I can go in here and I can click new, and I can put in, we'll put in Sam, they'll say you're my client. And then where this PDF is hard-coded, I can't change it. This is customizable. So I can go in and I can make a decision. Am I going to use the short code system or am I going to use the 24 information line? Well, maybe I want the 24 information line. So I could turn off the feature that would talk about short code. Then I click save and I come down here to exposure. Maybe I don't have a blogger account, so I turn off the blogger feature so it doesn't talk about it. In Utah, I always turn off Craigslist. Nobody goes to Craigslist in Utah at all. So when I'm done, I click save, and I can go down to the bottom, and there's that video with Sam's name on it. Make sure my volume's on.
Representative, today I'd like to walk you through my marketing program.
And it'll play in a male or a female voice.
You're listening for the most okay. And the quickest time.
And this video will completely explain that marketing system for you. Now, if you're using this in front of a client, like on your iPad or your phone like this, after a few times, you don't want to hear that voice anymore. You just pause it, and you can use it as a slide presentation in front of them. Here's how I like to use this. Sam, I'm coming over tonight. We're going to talk about listing your home. Okay, I've got a really quick video that I'm going to text over to you or email, right? However they like to communicate. Mm-hmm. I'm going to email this over to you. Can you watch this video before I get there? It's really short, about 5 minutes. It's going to completely outline my marketing program. If you could watch that before I come, you and I can spend more time talking about pricing your home right to get it to sell and what we need to do to get things staged and ready, because you'll know how I'm going to market that. Is that fair? So I send that over. She's got a little pre-presentation sent over, and I look like the high-tech agent, right? Because I'm using technology to talk about my technology that I'm going to use to market their home. So all of that is included in what you have. Now, we do have a new system that you guys, that the office is not providing for you at this time. And it's called Pix Social.
You've got
it. You're using it.
Yeah.
Okay, well, we'll let everybody else see what you're using. I love Pix Social. Pix Social is a phenomenal tool because the challenge with social media is that you have to be very consistent in what you're doing to keep what we like to call top of mind awareness. Everything is shifting into that whole social media sphere. So the more active I am on social media, the better I look to my friends and family and clients from a real estate perspective. So what we've done to help you do this is that we've developed 15 categories for content. When you sign up for Pix Social, being a current client, you get a significant discount. This runs $50 a month for folks that are not current clients. And since Realtek is paying for Pix Marketing for you guys, you can go right onto to our website and order Pix Social for $20 a month. Okay. In the setup for Pix Social, you select at least 10, but I would select all 15 of those categories. Okay. What's going to happen is our system will then go out and create, grab an article and post it onto your Facebook, your Twitter, and your LinkedIn, and you can have a new article post up to 4 days a week on all three of those social media platforms. Now, if the office were to sign up for this, then we would guarantee with 200 agents, we would guarantee that nobody would get the same post on the same day. Where you're doing it individually, you could get some of the same articles posting on the same day, okay? The next thing we do is we post holiday content for you. So did you pick this up at NAR?
No. I got called on it, but I don't remember them calling it Pix Social, and I think I pay more a month for it.
Should only be paying $19.95 a month.
Yeah, that's I might be. I'll have to check. I got so many things coming in at one time.
Yeah, I received a call too.
Yeah.
We'll post holiday content for you. You select the holidays you want us to post content for. We'll post it. If it's a religious holiday, it doesn't religious or non-religious posts. But my favorite feature is the marketplace listings. I'm a part-time agent, so I have one personal listing right now. So what I've done is I have the system posting listings from my office onto my social media. So I have four articles a week and four listings a week post to my Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn, and I look amazing. I'll give you an example of what happened.
I don't think they do that for me.
No, they don't do that.
No, they only do my own listings.
He did not mention to go in and choose 15 categories or whatever. I just saw them pop up.
Well, he probably helped you.
He set it up and everything.
He set it up?
It was already.
The broker has to authorize the sharing of the listings. Do you know if there's an issue with them being able to share office listings?
Not that I'm aware of, but I wouldn't be the decision maker on that, but I'll find out for you.
Alan let me do it for Savvy, so I don't know.
Well,
that's with board, so.
Let's go over, let me show you. Where is my stupid mouse? Oh, we're still on this. Sorry, guys, I gotta figure out how to. You're like, hey, the tech guy can't even figure out his computer.
There it is, it's up at the top.
Okay, so this is my business page right here. I hate that they've added this stupid stuff. So when you scroll down on my business page, the first thing you come to is an article. This article is a photography-based article, talks about drones, just, you know, that's a fun article. When they click on that article from my Facebook page, it opens up a page. Hopefully their internet's not this low.
Takes long sometimes.
And it's not loading the article. Let's find a different article. Here we go. I like this article. This is the 10 of the most colorful places in the United States. So when they click on this, it opens up the article. There, that one loaded all right. And they can says, look at the top.
Mm-hmm.
My branding.
Yeah.
And a button to find out what my home's worth. We're trying to turn this into more engaging content. So right now the lead generation is set up as find out what my home's worth. Now, you saw I skipped by a listing. That is not my listing, okay? My listing has tons of snow in front of it. When they click on that listing though on my Facebook page, it rebrands this to a mini tour with me as the agent.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now if I scroll down to the bottom, this does belong to Brandy Tyler from my office. It's her listing, but it's on my Facebook. It's on my Twitter. I'm having 4 articles and 4 listings post a week. And what happens is when they go on that article, so when they go to this article and they click on it like we did, it opens it up and they click on that button to find out what my home's worth, it brings them over to a nice landing page like you're looking at right here,
mm-hmm.
where they just type in their address and answer a question. You wanna sell your home in the next year? Yes, no, maybe. Put in your email address, they click send estimate. Now remember, these people already know you, like you, and trust you anyway. They're your social media friends, okay? This is the email you as an agent will get from us if they do that. It says, hey Sam, you just got a big social lead from Home Valuation from Marty Nicholson. Here's Marty Nicholson's information. And this is the email we sent to Marty that says, hey Marty, thanks for reaching out. I'm happy to help you find out what your property's worth. Every home is unique. In order for me to really get a good value in your home, I need to ask you a few questions. We are not going to Zillow them, right? We want you to provide that information. Same thing if they go into that property site and if they ask a question, it's not going to the listing agent, it's on your social media. It's going that they ask a question, it goes to your inbox. Here's the reason why this is so important. Most agents either they do not have social media accounts, or if they do, they're never posting anything. With Circlepix, if you get a listing with the Pix marketing, you're automatically getting your listing posted to your social media. If you add Pix Social, we'll be adding additional listings to your social media. Now we're gonna, in addition, post relevant content. All you need to do is simply respond to some of the likes, comments, and shares. Here's some examples of what's happened to me over the last year using Pix Social. I've had 3 examples. Number one, March of last year, I got a call. I used to live in Vegas. As we were moving out of Vegas, another family moved into the church we go to, and immediately everybody starts, you know, liking you on Facebook. We left. I really could barely even tell you who these people are. And I got a call, I got a Facebook message last year from the wife saying that her father-in-law lives in Utah with a town over from where I am living, was diagnosed with cancer, and they needed to move into Vegas, and they needed somebody to list the home. Now, I wasn't able to list that home because he was upside down in that home. So they're renting it till we recover that. But they, who did they call? Me, because they've been following me on social media. Second example happened where I have a friend that moved to Indiana call me, says, we're moving back to Utah, and I wanna use you now. He could have him and I have been in contact. He could have used me because he just knows that I've gotten real estate, but he always is making comments on the stuff I'm posting. The third example, though, just happened in December, and this kind of floored me. I've got a guy that I served a mission with in the Philippines 23 years ago. Didn't know him before and have had very little contact with him since. In the last 10 years, I'll bet him and I have only talked maybe 5 times. He called me up and says, Marty, I'm getting a divorce and I need to get a value on my home for the judge. And when the divorce is final in January or February, I want to list the home and I want you, too. And I said, okay, this is interesting. I said, why are you calling me? What made you think of me? Because I know he's got other friends that are real estate agents. He said, I have been following you on social media and you are killing it. He says, you have posting some of the most beautiful homes. He says, how do you even have time to travel for that other company you're traveling for? I mean, this guy's, are you stalking me? How do you know where? But he's like, you're killing it. The only thing posting to my social media is stuff that Circlepix is doing. It has given my center of influence the top of mind awareness to keep me in front of them. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. So that now what we've done is we can complete that circle. Whether photography to market the listing, Pix marketing to enhance that marketing for you and the agent, but Pix social to really get you out there in front of your center of influence so that they know you are the professional. So as that's a wrap up on my PowerPoint. You guys wanted to see the back office. So let's just do this. Let me see if this living mirror. All right, this is gonna be easier. Now I can see what's going on. Okay, so you go to circlepix.com. Now, this is where you can go to Pix Photography to order any of our photography packages. But over here to the right, you just click login. And your username is your email address. And your password, if you've never logged in, is most likely 1234. If that doesn't work, you're going to need to call the 800 number, which is on the back of the flyer that you have in front of you, and they can reset your password. So let me go ahead and log in. So now I've already done my setup wizard. So if you've already set yours up, this is the page it loads into. And when you click over here, this is posted listings because I got demos. If this was my live account, my agent account, it would say active listings, right? So from here, I can click on that and I could select any one of my listings. But for your sake, you'll click on manage my account. Mm-hmm. When you first log in, you have to click manage my account first, and then you click agent setup. Most of this information we already have because we've pulled it from the MLS or got it from RE/MAX Realtek. So your name, your office address, the office phone number, that stuff's there. Your email address, but your cell phone number you need to add, your state license, your personal website, so your agent website you need to add. Okay, Facebook. Open up a separate window for Facebook. Copy the URL at the top and paste it into the Facebook tab. Same thing for Twitter, YouTube, LinkedIn, Pinterest, and your Blogger. Now remember, when don't just go to YouTube and copy YouTube. It's got to be your YouTube channel, right? Be in your YouTube channel when you do that.
On that, does it tell you where, for example, I have a Circlepix ad here on Facebook, uh-huh. Okay? And it's going to M. Sam McLaughlin. Now I have another page, business okay. page, and I don't think anything goes to the business page. It goes all to that M. Sam McLaughlin.
I'll show you how to change that.
Okay.
Okay, so when I click next, I can go in and type in my biography, right? What I want my biography to say. If I have a biography video, I can upload the video. I click next. See, I deleted my photo. Well, let's I don't even know where that file is on my computer.
I know, that's the problem.
So I gotta go, see, I did this in another one. So you upload your photo, click next, and then it will, it's just not letting me move on because I deleted my photo. So marketing tools, it'll take you over to a section where you do marketing tools. You select your template. You can look at the different templates for your flyers. Once that's been selected, you click next. Goes over to listing exposure. And this is where you're going to be able to see all of your Facebook pages. So if you have multiple pages, you can see that I have a Team True Vision page for another company that my wife and I do. It's a network marketing company. So I don't want my real estate stuff posting there, so I didn't check that one. This is my Circlepix one, so I'm not posting my demo accounts to my real estate, and then but I am posting to my personal page here. So I can select the number of pages that I want it to post to. I push connect and it connects to my Twitter. I push connect and it'll go to my LinkedIn. I push connect and it'll go to my YouTube, and I push connect and it'll go to my blog.
You can almost see how many accounts you have by doing that too, right? Or you set that up? Okay.
Yep. So once that's done, you're done.
So I can put both pages on there.
Yep.
Okay.
So then you come over here put in your PIN for your sign writers for you to, there's a phone dialing system there. And then client communication. This is how we communicate with you. So let's say you have an assistant, you want them to get copied on all the leads that are generated. You could go in and add another email address. You can have the text go, maybe you have a partner that you're partnering with. You can have them get copies of those texts and emails as well. When you're done with that, you're done. You never need to touch this again. It's automatically going to happen for you.
I have one other question for you. On this ad, the Circlepix ad, I updated the picture in MLS. It's not updated in Circlepix. Is there a reason for that?
I'm sorry?
On this Circlepix ad, I updated the picture in MLS and it's not updated.
When did you do that?
A while ago.
Can you have Natalie look at this listing for her?
Okay, what's the address?
4505 Roanoke Way. It's Roanoak Way.
Well, did you change the photos?
Yeah, I changed the photos. And you know what? Cross that one. I'll give you another address.
Because it may not change there, but if you click on it, you would click on that listing.
It's not doing anything. Let me give you 872 Cypress Cove. That's the one that's really a problem.
Have my kids been playing with your iPad?
Yeah, I dropped it. Oh, right on the corner.
You see, you're in the old tour viewer, but I'll bet you if you go through these photos, that photo is in there.
Okay.
It just doesn't change
the
front.
That's the one that I really need to have checked. Okay. And I'll check it myself, but if you could check it too, Jane, I'd appreciate it.
So, and if you can also go from, to make it simple for you to go add, to change your to what pages it's posting to since you're already set up. You don't go to the setup wizard. Under manage my account, come down here to social media.
Uh-huh.
Click on that.
Oh, okay.
And you can be able to go, you can go in and do it from here. You can add or modify connections.
Okay.
And then that will bring up that page. That way you don't go through the setup wizard again and change anything.
Right.
Like I've done. So, which I get to go back.
And delete it.
And the other thing that they're working on that will take, it's going to take us all year to get this done because it is a huge undertaking, is that we're completely revamping the back office. And making it, I mean, just, we're gonna make it so easy my dad can use the back office, okay? So that will all change this year as well. Our job is to, again, our job is to keep you on the leading edge of technology, so there's no reason why you should have to go anywhere else. We appreciate you guys, y'all's business. We love working with all of RE/MAX. We appreciate working with your group. And our customer service, the number is on the back of these flyers that you have. Do not hesitate to call these guys. I would tell you they speak English, but they're from Utah. So it's kind of...
I just like the fact that about the open house thing is brilliant because I've tested it out, and as soon as you open that video, it comes up
Where does that go? I feel like I'm close because I've tried it, but I'm really not.
It's, you know, when our videos go, like, where that when you make the circle, when Circlepix makes the tour, then that tour gets put out to all these places. So when you put in that there's an open house, all it is that when someone clicks on that tour, the information on the open house comes up. So wherever that tour is where that open house information is going to go. So, and it actually comes up first. When you click on the tour, it'll come up open house, the date and time.
Yeah, I didn't know this. Well, and is it a big, you say that you do it on like Fridays before the open house. Is there a turnaround time that you need to do it, the earlier the better? Because I had found that if I was trying to advertise for an open house, say like this Sunday, the earlier the better.
Yeah.
Because like the Zillow site, it's really the real
time. I check MLS
and come on.
Yeah, well, what I'm doing is I'm checking MLS every day. If it's in, or if, like,
are we getting your feed through ListHub?
Yes.
Okay. Then it takes time for
I thought it can take a couple days.
It can. So
anytime I would go put houses, it's come up immediately.
Even at the actual site.
What I did was to test it out as I put it on, and then I went in and just Googled houses for sale. Clicked on one that I knew I put the open house on, it took me to realtor.com or Zillow or something, and as soon as I clicked on the tour, it came up that there was an open house.
See, I thought when the feed comes from MLS, it can take a couple of days, that's why I go directly
into. But she's making the change directly in CirclePix, not through ListHub.
Oh, yeah, so maybe that helps.
So that's why it's not going through the feed, because it's the same link, right? So it's just been updated in CirclePix.
Yeah.
Now, if she had made the change, if she had to do that to the MLS, then it would take time. But that's why she's doing it directly in the
background. But I need to kind of have a better understanding or see where those videos are all being pushed, because I don't even really know, to be honest. I guess I'm still kind of new.
You are amazing.
When I took the call, because I wanted to learn the back end of it, so if anybody had questions, I could help them out. And then when I found out all the other things it can do, you can make a brochure up to market yourself, you can make a brochure up to market a listing, flyers, open houses, e-postcards, that you could even get and generate leads through it. And that, and there's a bit on there when you announce an open house, you can check mark a box which checks all your leads to let them know that you've got
That and I clicked it, but I'm like, but where are they getting those leads? Just through, again, the CirclePix.
Yeah, that's what I didn't understand.
Sure, why not? Whatever leads you have, we'll send. I don't even know where.
Well, there's 19 lead generators built into our system for you.
So as long as you have your agent set up done correctly, you've got all your information.
I think that's what I need to go back and try to make sure it's all accurate.
Right.
And as far as like the personal websites, is that automatically set up, or do you, because I like to try and actually do that as well.
But. Well, the individual websites, it's a website specific to that listing. And it's automatically generated. What I need to do is I need authorization to switch you to that newer
site. Yeah, I'm waiting to hear back from
Thank you so much, Marty.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Appreciate it.
I'm waiting on confirmation that that's okay, that I can go ahead and do that.
Because I'm going to tell you right now, it's a lot better than what you're using.
Yes, I don't like the one that we're using right now looks like a book.
Yeah.
Whereas that one looks more like a website.
I hate the old tour.
And it's more scrolling, whereas that one you have to actually click on each individual.
And they won't. Right? They won't.
Oh, it's too much. You open a can of worms. I'm like, okay, I'm going to try some new stuff, and then all of a sudden.
And then I get confused with CirclePix and Facebook, and I don't know where the hell I am.
Yeah.
Just to let you know as well that I have access to everything that you have access to. So if you want, let me know. I can do it for you.
So I will say that.
I just took it upon myself
Facebook.
To do it with back.
Facebook makes it so easy.
I didn't even know that.
Because the good thing is
I'm going to have to get your attention again. Have you kind of officially taken over then for.
So the stuff that you're doing with the Facebook ads that you post, where are you going to post those posts?
I sometimes post your posts. But sometimes I like to make my own.
Absolutely.
Because on my own, right on the front, I have like, say, the lead picture, and then I put four of the pictures that I think would really showcase that house in their ad. I don't know. I guess I'm partial to the way I like to set it up.
No, that's fine.